wanted to show this off. Like, I've never done something like this before. Actually, I'm going to close my door real quick. I have dogs surrounding me. Only because I have food in the room at the same time. But, I want to try something. So, I'm going to do a full unboxing of my new board game, Dune Imperium. And this is brand new game, came out by Direwolf Games, and it's also in partnership with the company called Legendary, who does a lot of the movies and stuff like that. This is their symbol right here. Everyone is very familiar with that if you've watched anything popular in the cinemas. So, first things first, we have this wonderful, wonderful looking book. We have this nice, crisp, beautifully detailed, and it is nice, like, good texture. And I love the little story they have here. It says, "In all the known universe, there is no more precious resource than the spice melange. Found only on the harsh desert planet of Arrakis, known also as Dune. Control of the spice is a focal point of conflict among the great houses of the Imperium. In its pursuit, those vying for power seek alliances and support to secure their position. The governing counselors of the Landsraad, I think that's how you say that, the Choam Company, and its insatiable hunger for profit. The far-sighted Ben Gesserit," I think that's how you say it. These names are very foreign to me. "The Ben Gesserit, the Spacing Guild with their monopoly on fold space technology, the Fremen, resilient warriors of the desert, even the Empire, its emperor himself, is not above the struggle for dominance. Conflict is inevitable, and its outcome is uncertain. One thing is certain, however, whoever controls the spice controls the universe." So the whole premise of this game is there are X number of rounds, and at the end of all those rounds, if no one has still reached a specific number of points, then the game is over. You count the number of points everyone has. Highest point total wins. Pretty simple. The way you can win, though, is there are two different ways. The way where after X number of rounds, if no one has won at that point, then you declare who's a winner based off point totals. Or if someone reaches 10 or higher points at the start of a turn, everybody then goes into the in-game phase where they count their points and determine who has won. So, first things first, we have all the nice books here. This is the rule book here, the one I just read this nice little story from that I struggled through. Then we also have here, we have the solo and the two-player variations guides, which is really nice. All this paper is just very nice texture. Then we have the board guide that tells you what each space does and explains them out very thoroughly. And then we have all of our nice little tokens here that we have in this nice little piece here. And these are items that are absolutely needed for the game. I don't know about these. I don't know what these are. Probably for two and one player games. This is one of the coolest things in my opinion. I think this really shows as a company they knew what they were doing. And it's a small thing. Very small. But I've never seen this inside of a box before. Of all the mini games I have. And I'm going to move my camera real quick and show you. I have a large collection of games here. And they're all underneath here too. And there's some more on that shelf in this area right here. So I've opened up a significant amount of games, and there's never been this little touch
And this little touch is all it took to really push me over the edge on the how amazing this company is already. Just this small piece of foam for the board. There are four of these holding the board in place so it does not rattle around. Something as simplistic as that, and not having just a piece of plastic that the board sets into, sets the game apart and makes the game feel special. And I will always keep these small pieces of styrofoam for that reason, because the game is that much more important to me now. And now we have this fantastic board that is actually not as big as I thought it was going to be. I thought it was massive. But in turn, like, it's actually only a 2x2 square. And so it's not as big as the board I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a 2x3, but it's only a 1x2. So it's very surprising how small that was. Then we have what's next in here. I'm trying to be nice to this. Okay, so this is just like a little cover piece, which I've another piece, great boxing to it. Then we have all of our cards. I really love the fact that it has the nice gold strip around all of it, and it's just like a normal like a deck of cards or something like that. I can't remember, but I like that feature on a lot of things. We also have the combat cards, which these are what are used for the rounds. So there are 10 combat cards ranging from 1s, 2s, and 3s. There's a single 1, X number of 2s, and X number of 3s. And these give you rewards and stuff like that. So the game is actually fairly complicated initially. But I got to watch a couple different people play the game last night as I was going to bed. And I was very impressed at how simplistic the game became once I understood the combats. Because if you can get past the combat, the game is very simple and straightforward. And then we also have all these nice baggies here we have the nice baggies of all our little tokens here. And then this here is the spice indicator. We have the bigger ones that are, I think, are 5. And then the little ones are just single count. And then we have our little warriors. Yeah, like those. Awesome. One of our other precious things, we have water. Little water droplets. And then we also have a special character. I do not know how to pronounce this character's name. But he has a special place on the board. And then you could take them, like, once a turn or something like that. These are garrison. These are, your soldiers or whatever you use for combat. And then there's also the same ones in different color. Then we have the purchase. These are your money. I cannot remember what they call these either. Also, very happy, they included an extra bag, because I'm a person who, instead of having all these out in single bags or whatever, like, I would combine these two into one bag. I would combine really nothing. I might combine these round cylindrical hedrons with these little men. I combine all those together. I'd put Homeboy here in with these also. And then I would take all of that stuff and I would put it in one big bag. So, like, that's just the way I like to do things. And then the final thing out of the box is each of our little players, okay? And this is another cool feature. Another cool thing. It's honestly all about the initial unboxing when it comes to these products. If it doesn't look cool coming out of the box initially, it's never going to be fun to play, or it's never going to be like super exciting. You have all these various player characters you're going to get to play as. If you have not read the book that this is inspired off of, I actually have a copy here in my room. I'm going to grab here in a second from my bookshelf. And I'm going to show it to you. Because I feel like it's an important one because it falls underneath classics. Only because this is like one of the first sci-fi stories that was ever made. So let me grab that real quick. It is... All of this is completely inspired by an author. I think he was from like the 1930s, maybe 40s. I'm unsure off the top of my head. But this particular copy I have is the 50th anniversary copy of Dune by Frank Herbert. Very nice. Like, I haven't taken the time to read it. And it was kind of intimidating when I bought this particular copy because the text is actually fairly small for me. Small text like this or like the Lord of the Rings books can seem to be quite intimidating to me, and it can cause me to not want to read a book. I'm actually going to figure out when this was actually written. Original... It's showing 1984. Ah, there it is. Copyright, 1965. So this is pretty cool. You can buy it at any of your local Barnes & Nobles. It'll most likely be in your sci-fi section. Or if you go to their, like, collectors, like, book section, where they have, like, the U.S. Constitution, and then like one of them they'll have is like the Bible, then they'll have like Edgar Allan Poe's complete works, H.P. Lovecraft's A Complete Fiction, Dante's Inferno, and the Divine Comedy, not Dante's Inferno, the Divine Comedy. Sometimes they will have it grouped in with those. So other than that, like, I just wanted to do like this really quick unboxing. And I prescribe that everybody go out and at least attempt to read the book. I mean, even if you have to. And I know this is a very old thing to say. Go to the library and just rent it for 2 weeks. If you're not interested after 2 weeks, you could send it back, whatever. And I know that's a very old thing to say. Because, like, oh my gosh, you're going to go to the library and do that? No. Like, you can do that. If you like your hard copies. If you don't, you could just go to probably somewhere online and rent it. But yes, so other than that, I think that is everything I have. So signing out for the day, I just wanted to show this off. So hope everyone has a very wonderful day and a happy new year to everyone.